Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Enigma and you're watching Enigma Inc. Do subscribe to my channel for videos on Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus signs in Aries. This is for you all. This is a general reading. For more personals, you can check it out on my WhatsApp or Instagram. For personal readings and bookings, your reading will be delivered within 3 days. And manifestation workshop where I'm going to teach you how to make your own energy circle where you can, you know, manifest anything, literally anything, with the simplest way, and there is no time limitation for this workshop. So you can join in at New Year offer, and it's starting on January 11th. So make sure that you're there if you're interested. All right, you can enroll and participate. For that, you can contact us on WhatsApp or Instagram. Follow me on Instagram for daily updates and tarot related daily horoscopes, monthly and yearly horoscopes, and other updates. So now let's move towards your reading, Aries. What's happening here? Ooh, there's no communication with someone. You guys may have had a fight. Okay. Ooh, this could be a Scorpio, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, Scorpio mainly. I feel like this person is resisting communication because they're hurt. They ended this with you because you were not paying much attention to them. They had a lot to say, or you were not, like, you know, giving them the response they wanted. So this person is upset and they totally told you, they totally called off this and they wanted to move on forward and leave this behind because they made efforts and they just didn't feel reciprocated the same way. So they had a lot of issues and complaints, and I feel like this person led the situation. They have a lot to say. They're resisting communication. They do want to talk to you. They want to be with you, but they're resisting it totally. For them, they made up their mind that it's over. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. I do see like your person's very focused on money as well. Although you're always there on their mind 24/7, they think about you. They want to come towards you with a communication, but they resist, as I told you. And they're very focused on their pinnacles, like making money, and they're working really, really hard wherever they are. So they want to be heard. They want to be understood. So that's what they expect from you. I feel like they think this connection is not based on mutual understanding. That what they want you to deliver to them, they don't feel that they're getting it from you. So they're leaving the situation deep inside. They want to connect with you for on a deeper level, but they just cannot. Okay, they find it so burning. They've worked on it, but they feel like they're putting their hands on fire, which is not of any use. So right now I feel like they're working really, really hard making money, and they're upset. So they're distracting all of their disappointment towards their work, and they just want to focus on it. So they're trying to avoid you. Okay. And with the Four of Cups, they don't feel loved and understood by you. That's the main message that I'm getting with Four. They just want to be left alone for now. They need space. They need time to get better. I also feel like with the Seven of Swords and Ten of Pentacles, this person has issues with marriage, relationship, commitment. I feel like they fear getting involved. Okay, they want your involvement, but when it comes to becoming together forever or committing in a connection, being together, you know, saying yes to the commitment, they find it really, really, really difficult. They're scared of this. Okay, so also see, like, maybe there's a status difference. You're better than them, and this scares the shit out of this person. Okay, so some sort of a status that is building a barrier between you guys. This person is fearing a lot of things, like some sort of insecurity, certain things they cannot express or tell you. So I feel like this person feels like you're much above their league. Some of you are married and this person is unmarried, or they're married and you're unmarried and there's a situation like that happening. This person is running away because one person is already committed or married. Maybe you are. And then this person wants you, but then they know that they cannot have you, so it's not right to be in this connection, so they're letting it go. Or it could be vice versa, since this is a general read. But I do see like there's something where I feel like it is not you know, legal. This connection is not legal somewhere. Okay, So this person is very attracted to the way you look, okay? Your personality, your looks, your attraction level is so high. They're attracted to you like anything. And this person is like, you know, wanting to have a physical closeness with you. They want to have a physical closeness with you, okay? They want to get involved with you, but then they know that this is not right, so they're pushing themselves away themselves only. So here I feel like definitely Aries, this person is going to reach out, or you are going to reach out to them because you know that this person is into you. It could also mean that you are getting married to someone else and they don't like this news and they're letting you go, or there's some sort of disagreement between this connection, this relationship. It cannot happen. So I feel like you also feel that strong attraction and pull towards them. And you are going to make this person understand a certain situation. And I feel like this person is kind of kiddish or, you know, immature in understanding what should be done, what should not be done. They don't listen. They just do what they think is right. Okay. Judgment. Yeah, you are worried about what people would say, or they're also worried about what people would say. But then I feel like there's a lot of attraction towards you guys, between each other. Okay, there's a lot of attraction between you guys. Okay, yeah, I do see like this person is making a decision to reach out to you soon. Okay, but right now they're not in a positive energy, and I feel like after having a little bit of disappointments here and there, they're gonna come back to you. So this is like Six of Pentacles is also telling me that they may have had a breakup, okay? They were going to get married and then they got broken. That marriage got broke and then they're like, oh my God, this was the one for me. Aries was the one for me, and they come back to you. That also is valid. I do see them looking at you as a wish come true. Like they see you as a beautiful soul, as someone who they can rely and trust on. I feel like they're coming towards you with some sort of a help, or you might help this person. So somewhere I feel like there's this giving and taking involved, and they're going to reach out to you and be thankful about certain things, okay? So yeah, this person is just not being able to get over you. They're looking for marriage. I feel like maybe you rejected their marriage offer, that is why they're leaving you behind, but they're coming back. They're still watching you on social media, like they're wondering what's going on in your life, Aries. Okay, I feel like Aries, you on the other hand are very focused on money, your pentacles. You're growing like anything. This growth, like tremendous growth happening in 2022, where your career is going to shift to another level. Like this is going to move really faster, and the money is going to grow, and it's going to be a fast moving money. I also see you becoming more popular, people really recommending you out of the other counterparts. But I do see like this person is actually keeping a close watch on social media, and they really want to reach out to you, but they're resisting that. They're resisting that heavily. Yeah, they're scared of being cheated on, or they're the one who cheated on you and you're leaving the situation. Yeah, they're not liking the fact that you're leaving them for someone else. This is possibility from any of you side. Okay, so you might got engaged with someone and they're not liking it and they feel deceived like that, or you may be already with someone else and they feel deceived here. Okay, you said something that hurt this person, literally hurt them. They want this friendship back. They want your friendship. What else? Unrequited. See, I told you, there is love there. Okay, they know that you're the one for them, but then this cannot happen because of some situation. There's something that's not legal here between you guys. Okay, something that's a taboo in this connection. I feel like they want you, but they just cannot have you, and that is creating a lot of stress in their mind. They want to come towards you. They miss that flirting and lighthearted time with you guys, but they really want something strong. Like they see you as the one for themselves. All right, Aries, they see you as the one. What other things? Pride. I feel like your person is too proudy, and that is what is creating a lot of blockage in them expressing what they actually want. And because they cannot express it, they ended it right away. And somewhere it left you confused, Aries, why they ended it. You know, somewhere you feel like, okay, what did I do? What was my fault? I just stayed honest. Okay, I feel like Aries, on the other hand, you're simply enjoying your own life. And I feel like you're getting attention from the options around you. Very strong attention. Someone is really appreciating the way you look. And you're really happy where you are. So it's not like you're dependent on this person. But yeah, this person is actually dependent on you. The temple. Yes, you're going to move towards some sort of getting marriage. You know, getting into a traditional marriage. Getting married or, you know, something sacred is happening in your life that you're very focused on. You're becoming more spiritual. Okay, so that is your focal point. Yeah, you're going to find a person that's like a treasure for you. You're going to feel complete. Okay, finally you're going to get someone who you're going to be with and you're going to feel complete. Or you found your treasure, okay? Be it money, be it love, but you found something that makes you feel complete. You really don't need them. But yeah, this person is like hung up on you like anything. Now let's see from Aries to Pisces, their feelings towards you. Aries on another Aries. Aries is finding you as someone who grounds their energy. They feel like you make them feel good about themselves. Okay, this could be you. Very focused, money oriented, and money is growing. Taurus wants a relationship, so that's an offer coming in. Gemini is in love with you already. I'm sensing really nice vibes for you, Aries. Okay, Cancer. Okay, Cancer is talking you, studying you, like wondering what's going on in your life. Leo. Leo wants it over because they're hurt. Virgo. Virgo is like want to start afresh. Maybe there's someone new that you met. Libra. Libra is seeing you as the only one for them. Scorpio. Scorpio is feeling like this is too burdening, so they want to let it go. Okay, they want to work on this, but they're letting it go. Sagittarius is keeping a close watch on you, but they're right now cold-hearted due to some reason. Capricorn wants stability, commitment, soulmate, bond, possible. Aquarius. Aquarius is not very healthy. Right now they're going through a lot, and they may be having sleepless nights. Maybe because you're not focusing on them. Pisces is focused on money, or they're trying to manifest you as well. This could also mean that. So yeah, that's about it, Aries. I hope you've enjoyed the reading. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe, hit the bell, and comment below and let me know how this resonated. Follow me on Instagram. Bye.